Okay, so I posted earlier today, what did you guys want to see? A box or a bag? And I'm still cracking up because somebody went in there on the Chicken Scratch online side and added a card and all three. And that is so funny. It cracks me up. We are only making a box tonight, though. I just returned home yesterday afternoon from our Christmas travels. So my office is a disaster area, and that's putting it mildly. So I did try to get caught up on email today, and I got a few things done, but not a lot. But anyway, I'm working all day tomorrow and Friday as well, so hopefully I'll make some headway. We're gonna start with, I got out some Real Red and Whisper White cardstock since we are making a Valentine project. And the Designer Series paper, let me get the whole pack real quick. Here it is. I've shown it to you a number of times already. What I did, and I actually didn't do it, when I was at On Stage in November, at each table, they had cut this paper in half. And so each table got one half, and I got the leftovers. And I thought, wow, that's a really awesome idea. Because then it challenged me to see what could I come up with using a half a sheet of the 6x6, which is 3x6. Anyway, so we're going to be using that pattern, which there's lots of lovely patterns in here, but this is one of my favorites. Okay, let me get out my paper trimmer. The box that we're making today, I've only made one other time, and I know it's one that was a little confusing, so I'm making it tonight. Oh, that's funny. Julie said she wants to. Did you say you want to see the disaster? There is no way. Girl, you cannot pay me to show you my disaster. Okay, so I'm going to cut this to measure 8.5, which it's already 8.5, by 5. So that means you can get two of these boxes out of one sheet of Real Red cardstock. And do I need to cut any more? Not yet. So we'll put this away for a second. And if you're new to my live events on Facebook, the recording will be available afterwards, and I will look it for questions periodically. Okay? So I'm going to place this in landscape. And I don't know if you guys remember the 2, 4, 6, 8 box. Love that thing. I almost made that tonight, but I just couldn't. Anyway, so I'm going to score it at 2, 4, 6, and 8. And then I'm going to turn it on the portrait side, which is the 5-inch side. Boy, that looks a little shy of 5, but maybe it's not. And I'm going to score it at 2 and 3. Okay, now we've got this half inch side over here. So now what we're going to do is take the, what is this called? Scallop tag topper punch. Oh, I just realized I don't have my grid paper. That's okay. I'll get it out when I start to stamp. So there's a score line here. There's a score line every 2 inches. So this one down here that has the half inch strip, we're going to shimmy this thing inside here. Okay, and what we want to do is center it between those two score lines. And it's not going to be perfect. There's one score line right there and one score line right there. We're just centering it and punch. That's what it's going to look like. I'm going to do the same thing on this one. So we're going to skip one and do the next one. Okay. Same thing. I'm just centering it. Holy Toledo. I think I just broke my punch. Let's see. Don't ask me how this thing goes back in there. I have a drawer full of them. I don't know. Anyway, I never lock mine anyway. Now let's take our scissors. We're going to stay on this half inch side over here. And what we're going to do is remove everything but this little section right there. So I'm going to cut up to the score line and then remove. And the same thing here. That one's done. Now we're just going to move to the left and we're going to cut up to the score line on each of these. We want to make sure that we don't disturb our scallop topped pieces, so I'm going to fold those down and out of the way, and then I'm going to give these pieces just a sliver of a trim, okay? Not a lot, as you can see. Now we're going to go to the bottom of the box and we're going to cut up to the score line on all of these score lines. Okay. Now I'm just going to fold these on the score line just to make sure that our box has nice crisp edges. You don't have to, but it certainly makes a difference. One more. Okay, I'm going to place this back on the Simply Scored scoring tool. It still would have looked cute, but not as cute. So we're going to fold up this piece and fold up this piece. And we're going to score it 1 inch. That's what I get for looking at the eagle over here to the left of me. Okay. Now we'll start over with the adhesive. I'm just going to fold this over. It's a little bit easier doing it that way. So this is the back of the box. This is going to be the front. So I'm going to flip this over. I always want to put the seam of the box or the bag to the back, just in case it doesn't look as good. There we go. Okay. Now, what to put in here before I seal this? So this is the size. I always get these questions, is what can you put in there? So you can put three of the little mini Ghirardellis, or you can put, I think, five or six Hershey Kisses. Four actually looks good. Five is a little tight, so I would say four. I don't want to put any candy in there. Okay. So here's our cute little box. Now we're going to decorate it. Okay? Now, one decision you do have is you could put adhesive here and adhesive here and attach them there. If you don't, it's going to pop up a little bit like that. I don't really care. I think it still looks cute, even if it's popped up a little. Yeah, it still looks good. Okay. I'm going to get my grid paper and my stamp. We're using Real Red ink. And the Love Notes framelits. And, oh dear. Hold on. I need a second to think. I have a plan. I thought about it. I'm getting some grid paper so I don't stamp on my table. Okay, while my thought comes back to me, what we'll do is we'll cut the designer series paper. Like I said, this piece measures, let me get everything positioned here, 3x6, and I need, where's my cheat notes? I need 4 pieces that measure 1 7/8 by 7/8. So I'm going to cut this at 1 7/8. I got this left over. And then I'm going to cut at 7/8. So the 7/8 is the one big mark right before the 1. And I need 4 of these. 2, 3, 4. Then I need 2 pieces that measure 1 7/8 by 3/4. So 3/4 is right there. 2 of these. You guys, a lot of you guys already know I am an apple freak. There's a lot of us out there. And you know, I tell you one thing. I could talk for a couple hours about all of my Apple products, but I have learned a huge lesson, and that is don't listen to the negative Nellies. I'm not even real sure why I did, but for some reason, I listened to the negative Nellies, and I did not get the first generation Apple Watch. My husband got me the second generation, and I will never listen to the negative Nellies again. I don't know what they were complaining about, but I am in love, which I figured I would be anyway, but I love it, Dolores. Thank you for noticing. I look forward to getting a prettier band, although white is my favorite color, so it works. Okay, this is going to be so cute. I think I'm going to see if I can figure out how to make this box a little bit bigger. It's so cute, and it is kind of tiny. It would hold a ring, a bracelet that kind of, you know, rolls up. My husband got me also a really beautiful bracelet. I didn't wear it tonight. It kind of jingles a lot, but I do love it. It would not fit in this. Well, maybe it would. Actually, it would. It's upstairs. Okay, so there's the paper. Isn't that so pretty? Now for ribbon. I'm going to take this brand new, what is it called? Sending Love? I don't know. I'm taking 2 pieces of the Real Red. I could use the little where is it? I did grab a binder clip just in case I didn't like the direction I was going. It's gone. It disappeared. Oh, by the way, I lost an embossing folder. I have looked and looked and looked and looked and looked. And I think I've officially given up. I'm going to have to order it again. I needed it to do a video, and it has disappeared. I almost posted on Facebook today, how long do you look for an embossing folder before you give up and just order it again? I don't like losing things. Okay, so I thought about using the Candy Cane Lane Baker's Twine, but... And I thought about using the Cherry Cobbler. Even though this is Real Red, sometimes you can get away with using the Cherry Cobbler. But ultimately, I'm going to use the thick white. Although I do wish we still had the thin white. I love the thick white for certain projects. But I also like the thin. You know what I could do is I could separate this and get myself a couple little ones. Let's try that. I don't know if it'll work or not. I think it will. Yeah. And you're not the first person to say, is white a color? I've been told many a times that it's not a color. I guess I'm in a pickle since it's my favorite. In fact, my baby sister used to always tell me, you need to wear color. I don't know why white is my favorite. It just is. It's, I try to wear colors, but ruh-roh. Okay. So this sounded like a great idea, but it may not be a great idea. So that thought just came to me of separating them, but I may not like it after all. We'll try again. You're right. I glanced over at the comments. I probably will find it the minute I place the order, which if that's the case, that'll be fine. I'm ready to get that video filmed. I swear I've looked everywhere though. And I really keep things kind of sort of in their own place. So I don't know how I could have even lost it. Oh, this is cute. Yeah. Okay, come on. Well, I think I've fiddled with it just a tad too much. I want to make it a little bit smaller. Okay, after doing all that, I don't really like it. Sorry. Come back here. I'm going to leave it the way it is. Just the normal, it looks a little scraggly. Like it needed a haircut or something. It wasn't very clean. See, if I was filming this video, I would have just edited all that out. I made the box in itself faster than tying the ribbon. That's funny, isn't it? Okay, this one's much better. That other one just looked a little rough. A little bit smaller. There we go. Perfect. See? And then we'll give these guys a little trim. Cute, cute. Now, decorate it. I'm pretty sure I wanted to use the heart. I've stamped a bunch of cards, a bunch of things with this. And I'm going to use the Scent with Love this time. Here's how I get it on my block straight. I put it on my grid paper. If I can get it to stop sticking to me. Come here. Ugh. Come on. Where's my ink? Here it is. Real red. Isn't that pretty? It matches the paper. I love it. I need my trimmer real quick. What I'm going to do is cut a teeny tiny piece for the greeting. And I'm going to cut a couple different sizes. I want it as small as I can get it, but not too small, you know. I think both of those will work. or one of those. I can't see. Hold on. Let me get my glasses. Okay. That one's too low. I think the other one's okay. I'm going to give them a second to dry, because remember the last live video, I smeared it with my fingers. What we're going to use is this little framelit piece to cut that out. It does the coolest thing. Yeah, I think that's it on here. Let me get the big shot real quick. Oh dear. So big shot, magnetic platform, cutting pad. We're going to take our heart and place this right over the top. I think that's straight. Look how cool this is. Look. See? I love it. I didn't even know it did that until the first time I wondered why it had all those. Why it had that line and everything. Clearly I didn't read if it said it. I'm not sure. Okay. I don't want to lose this thing. Let's put it back on here. Let's get our box back over here. I still want to cut these a little bit shorter. And I'm going to add this to the front, just like that. Isn't that cute? So all I'm going to do is take some liquid glue. Okay, so for those of you that are watching, I'm going to draw a couple names tomorrow, and I'm going to give a pack of rhinestones to two of you. We're going to use the random generator. It's so much easier than counting and all of that. Okay, so I've attached that there. I want to give it a minute to dry. So I'm just going to set it aside for a minute, and then we're going to work on the greeting. And I did smear that one, but not this one. I'm going to take the classic label punch, and let's see. Ooh, that looks good. It's a little thick. I want to make it smaller. Yay, I didn't mess it up. I just removed like a hair. Yeah. Okay, where's my glue dots? Here they are. And my paper piercer. So I'm going to place a glue dot on this side. On the other side. And try to very carefully attach it without squashing it. Okay, that glue dot. So what I need to do really is put the glue dot on the heart instead. I thought about this project, but I didn't think about where I was going to add adhesive. Let's try again. Yeah, that looks good. Squash, squash, and then raise it back up. It's cute, isn't it? Heck yeah, that's darling. Thanks, Sharon. It is cute, isn't it? Valentine's is almost an extension of Christmas, so I can make all kinds of cute little boxes and bags for candies. And then after we get out of Valentine's Day, then we can move into Easter. And then there's Mother's Day and Father's Day, and then there's like a little lull period there for me. I'm like a fish out of water, so I try to concentrate on birthday stuff until we get the holiday catalog, which is kind of crazy. I'm talking about that. It's like, wait, the holiday catalog just ended. Or not yet. We still have it a few more days. Okay, I'm going to grab my iPad here really quick. Did I put the glue dot on the white outline or just on the inside heart? I just put it on the outline, Karen. Just the frame and just at the bottom. Yay, I got hearts. Yes, it would hold some sweetheart candy. In fact, it holds this cute little pack of them that I've been creating little treat holders to hold. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I told everybody, well, I posted on my blog, I should say. To me, that's telling everybody that I was going to show the Bella's Bundles number one. And if you guys have any questions, we don't really have to talk about it a lot tonight. I just want to go ahead and show the contents. It is missing the gift and the Skittle surprise, but I'm just going to move this project over really quick and kind of show you. I don't know what it is about organization and doing stuff like this, but I am loving it. Okay, so don't you guys love the Bella's Bundles logo? This is not actually one that's going in there. This was my prototype, I guess that's what you would call it. So everyone that orders it is getting the Sealed with Love stamp set along with the framelits. And then they get their choice of their celebration item, a pack of the... what is this? Sending Love DSP. I can never remember the name. And I think I said the ribbon. And then here are all the projects along with all the envelopes. And I thought it might be fun to ask you guys what you thought about. I love organizing all the materials for everything. And what I did several online workshops ago or something, I took all the stuff that we cut. It's got ribbon and everything. This is a pass one, not a Bella's bundle. But I put all their pieces in an envelope. And, well, that really severely confused people because they thought they didn't get all their pieces. But I was thinking that would be fun to do again for the Bella's bundles. But, oh, look at this one. This one had a lot of stuff. Whew. Anyway, so right now I have them in the cellophane bags. But I was kind of sort of thinking about using their envelopes. Anyway, you guys could tell me what you think. Okay, I'm going to look for questions. I'm going to move that back out of the way. So that's my little commercial break. Put this back in. Oh, hearts. Thank you. Okay, what's the question about how to measure? When I cut paper, why do I move the blade to top, from bottom to top? Julie, that really, honestly, it doesn't make a difference. Let me get a piece of paper. I naturally cut from the top to the bottom, but because I do that all the time, that sometimes I cut from the bottom to the top, just because. There's really no right or wrong reason. It's just however I'm feeling that day. You guys have a good night, and thank you so much for attending.